deeply insecure because we liked the sound of people clapping because it made us forget about how much we feel like we're not good enough. And I've been doing this for 15 years and I'm tired of it. I'm just tired of the... Just feels like it's more than music now at this point. And just most days I'm like, okay. But then sometimes I'm just like... It just gets loud sometimes.
I'm saying right now that this is something that I know is right, and you guys, I need to be on the right side of history.
Taylor,
and if he doesn't win, then at least I tried.
Taylor, here's the problem.
I just want to read you what I wrote, and I'm going to try to start. I just really want you to know that this is important to me.
I've read the entire thing, and the bottom line right now, I'm terrified. I'm the guy that went out and bought armored cars.
I worry for her safety as much as anybody does. Maybe more.
It really is a big deal to me. She votes against fair pay for women. She votes against the reauthorization of the Violence Against Women Act, which is just basically protecting us from domestic abuse and stalking. She thinks that if you're a gay couple, or even if you look like a gay couple, you should be allowed to be kicked out of a restaurant. It's really basic human rights, and it's right and wrong at this point. And I can't see another commercial and see her disguising these policies behind the words Tennessee Christian values. Those aren't Tennessee Christian values. I live in Tennessee. I am Christian. That's not what we stand for. I need to do this. I need you to just... I need you to forgive me for doing it, because I'm doing it.
I've been thinking about addiction, and I've been thinking about people who, if they're either suffering through mental illness or they're suffering through addiction, or they have an everyday struggle. No one pats them on the back every day, but every day they are actively fighting something. Mm. But there are so many days that nobody gives them credit for that.
Yeah.
And so how often must somebody who's in that sort of internal struggle must want to say to everyone in the room, you have no idea how close I am to going back to a dark place, or you have no idea.
You have no idea how hard it is to get to the point where you guys think is still shitty.
Yes, and then the second verse is about, someone who felt like they had a lot of potential in their life. I think there are a lot of mechanisms for us in our school days, in high school or college, to excel and to be patted on the back for something. And then I think a lot of people get out of school and there are less abilities for them to get gold stars.
Yeah.
And then you have to make all these decisions and you have to pave your own way, and there's no set class course you can take, and I think a lot of people feel really swept up in that. And so I was thinking about this person who is really lost in life and then starts drinking and every second is trying not to.
So I was thinking that this song could just be you and me and a guitar. What do you think? So I think that, in my opinion, one of the bravest things that a human being could ever do is to go through something absolutely unbearable and then share their experience with the world. And I think the braver you are, the more brutally honest you are. And, guys, this is sad. This is not, I'm just, there's a woman here tonight named Maya Thompson. And she has lived in this area and brought her kids up in this area, and I wouldn't know half as much as I know about childhood cancer and childhood cancer research if she hadn't shared her story about her son Ronan. And the thing about childhood cancer is it's really, really hard to talk about, and it's really not something that you bring up because it makes everyone really, really upset. But the fact that she brought it up, she had this blog called Rockstar Ronan, and I would read it every night. And was this account of what it's like to watch cancer take over your life. And since then, I've had cancer hit really close to me and my family. And so because Maya's right there, I would like for you to give her a round of applause, please. Blog, I decided that her account of things was so heart-wrenching and so honest that I took a lot of the things that she said and I put them into a song, and I put her as the co-writer because she is the rightful co-writer of the song called Ronin. And when we put it out, all the proceeds of that song went to the Ronan Thompson Foundation and other childhood cancer research. There are a lot of really, really incredible kids in this city who are getting some of the best medical treatment. And I just wanted to take a moment and try and play this song. I can't promise that I will sing it well or not get really emotional, but I'm gonna try, because the only other time I've played this was on a show called Stand Up to Cancer. And I think that because Maya's here tonight, I think she deserves it, because she co-wrote it.